Before we start recording the events between you and your client, we have to discuss startup documents. Startup documents are things like estimates, proposals, and quotes. Most people understand all three are the same thing with a different name, and for the most part, they are. Proposals and quotes sometimes are used as documents that we give to the client while we're negotiating. Then after we finish negotiating, we then make a main estimate, and that estimate is the document that we follow during the contract. When we have a contract with a client, the details of the contract are on the estimate, or the document that you could call the main job estimate. Proposals, quotes, and estimates are physically the same document with a different name. They are simply a different template. They are not transactions. Let's take a look. If we're here in QuickBooks, we can click from the main menu, Customers, Create Estimates, and a document opens up that has the word estimate on it. You can change the template to proposal, and it will be mostly the same document, except it will have the word proposal on it instead of the word estimate. If you choose quote, again, they're physically the same thing, but not only will it have the word quote on it, but you can see this particular template has fewer columns. It really does not matter which one you choose. Only the name will be different. All the other behavior will be the same. You can make them with what you suggest you will do for the client. After you agree on the different details with your client, you can make the main job estimate. And that's the document that QuickBooks will follow to determine what percent of the job is complete. Unfortunately, there is one template that you will have to make yourself. That's because sometimes clients pay in advance. When the client pays in advance, sometimes it's called a deposit or a prepayment. You will have to make that document to be able to give the client a deposit receipt. So let us make a job deposit template from a credit memo. From the main menu, we click Customers, Create Credit Memo. Notice the document that comes up says credit memo, and if we click this, we get the other template, return receipt. We will have to make our own receipt for client deposits, and it will say client deposit. In order to make our own receipt, we click the formatting tab from the menu, and then we click manage templates. Notice there are only two choices here. We'll click custom credit memo, and then we'll click OK. Then we'll click additional customization. Now, this is the additional customization window. This is the window where you decide what columns and column headings you want. The only thing I'm going to change is the word credit memo, and I'm going to change it to deposit receipt. And I suggest you leave it in lowercase because it might not fit on the document. When we click OK, and then click OK, and then click OK again, and then click OK again, we now have a document that says deposit receipt. So if we want a return receipt, we choose this one. If we give the client a deposit receipt, we choose the one that we just altered. And this is the document we will make when the client pays for service in advance or gives a deposit before we start the job.